little bit more on this celestial sphere, because as we go through, we realize we can get some of our key course questions answered. We can start with question number 43, which says, the sun always sets in the west, right? And we can extend that question just a tad bit to not just talk about the sun, but other stars too. Like, we know this old adage, things rise in the east and set in the west, but is that strictly true? Like, does the sun, as question 43 say, always set in the west? Now, we discussed this a little bit when we talked about the tilt of the earth, but the same thing goes for the stars. Do the stars always rise exactly in the east and set directly in the west? Well, we'll see about that. The celestial sphere will help us figure that out. Question 44 asks the question, is the North Star visible worldwide? Turns out it is not. I think you probably know that, but we'll see why with the celestial sphere. And then, of course, question 45 asks the question, where do stars go when they set? That wasn't a very easy question to answer very early on in astronomy. So let's see what the celestial sphere can do for us in that regard. Okay, so let's just take question 43, first of all, about the sun or stars always rising exactly in the east and setting in the west. So if I go back to my celestial sphere model here, what I'll do is I'll just add a random star. Let's say, there's one right there. There's a couple right there. Okay. There we go, right there. I just wanted to add some to get that are sort of north and be more familiar with us here. So what we'll do is let's sort of watch this star, I guess this star right here. See the one the mouse cursor on? Let's just watch that one for a minute here. I'll start the animation. So the first thing you see is it's sort of rising here. And up it goes. And it comes down now, and it sets right there about in the west. Okay, and that's pretty nice. So this is an example of a star that looks like it sets in the west. And what it does when it's setting, as mentioned in question 45, where do stars go when they set? Well, they go below the horizon. So you can see this star is setting, but really all that means is going below the horizon for us. Okay, so it took astronomers a while to figure that out. They thought, well, do stars go digging in the dirt of the earth or somehow hide underground before they come up? No. They just sort of go below the horizon. And so we can see again, if I pause the animation, that star just rose approximately in the east. And so that's a nice example of a star that seems like it rises in the east and sets in the west. Supports that old adage that we're used to. But look at this star over here now. There's one over here, which is not quite, it's not over here, it's a little bit over here on the celestial sphere. Let's just sort of watch what that one does as the animation runs. So here it goes. Here it goes, getting very high in the sky. Could be any star you see at night. Nice and high, just looking real straight up to see it almost, and then it comes down. And what it's doing now is it's starting to go down on the celestial sphere. It's rotating down, and I'll pause it just as it sets for us right here, right about there. Look, I stopped it right there. There's that star we're talking about right there. And you can see that it's not setting in the west, is it? It's closer to north than west, so we'll call it a northwest setting star. But that should answer that question for you there about, does the sun always set in the west, or stars for that matter, sun or stars? And the answer is no, they don't. Here's an example of a star that's setting in the northwest, purely due to its position on this celestial sphere relative to my location, right? So it's setting in the northwest. Likewise, if I run the animation some more, let's just watch what happens to the star as it rises again. So it's under the horizon right now, and I'll try to pause it just as it comes up again. There it is, right there. Did I miss it? Looks like, yes, I did miss it already, didn't I? There, it's rising again. So I'll speed up the animation. I think I missed it going the first time around. Let me try to capture that one again for you. So there it is, setting in the northwest. And here it comes up again. I'll pause the animation just as it rises, right about there. And so you can see there's that star again, rising, just coming up into our view. But it's clearly not rising in the east. There's east way over there. So this star is rising in the northeast. So that should be some pretty good answers for those questions for you right there. In terms of the setting direction is not always directly east or west. And likewise, we can see some other stars here in the sky. If I start the animation, like say these over here, these are actually rising in the southeast. As you can look at this one here, rising in the southeast and setting in the southwest, something like that. So that star there is very much not following that old adage either, because the old adage isn't true. It sort of depends on many, many things. Okay, and the last thing I'll show you in this video here is the one about the North Star being continuously visible through the whole Earth. Is that true? Can you see the North Star everywhere? Well, I'll pause the animation. We don't need that because it's very easy to show with the celestial sphere that the North Star is not visible everywhere on the planet. So let's just say I've got a couple stars. Let's just say that that one right there is the North Star. Say they're all just sort of added in sort of a weird way, random way, nothing we can sort of grasp onto. And so what I'll do now is I'll go to my location over here on the map on the left, and I'm just going to start lowering my, well, I'll raise my location. So if I go further north, over here, sorry, the map is over here. If I go further north on this map, you can see the North Star gets higher and higher. But as you go further south like this, look at where the North Star is. Right when I hit the equator, the North Star is very low. So if I go down below the equator, there's the North Star right there, right? Weird to see the North Star way down like that. But it's here below our horizon. So if we were in this section of the world south of the equator, we would not be able to see the North Star. And no matter where I go down here south of the equator, I cannot see the North Star. It's always below the horizon. But what I have to do suddenly is come up to the northern hemisphere again, and suddenly the North Star becomes visible. So no, the North Star is not visible worldwide. You must be in the northern hemisphere in order to see it.